Boone Pickens was from a small town in southeastern Oklahoma called Holdenville. Grew up in the Depression, ultimately moved to Dallas, Texas, and always remembered what his grandmother told him, which was, "Sonny, don't ever forget where you're from."
To me, T. Boone Pickens was larger than life. He was a legend. He was a storyteller.
In later years, I had a reporter ask Boone, "Boone, are you a Texan or are you an Oklahoman?" Boone said, "Well, I'm both." Years later, he told me, "You know what? I should have added Canada to the list." And I said, "Why?" He said, "Well, it all began in 1957 with the friendship I formed with Harley Hotchkiss."
My dad and Boone met when Dad was just starting out in his business. And Boone was the same. He came up from Texas and was starting a business here in Canada.
They had so much in common, born with little to no wealth, but became very accomplished together.
They valued hard work. I think they just hit it off right away. They just had a huge respect for each other.
Boone went to Calgary in 2008 to do a media avail with Harley and announced a multi-million dollar gift to the University of Calgary. When he started to give to, you know, brain research, you know, he was one of the early believers in the importance of it. Boone was always guided by the belief that it's great to make a lot of money, but also to be generous with it.
The legacy gift is incredible in so many ways. The mission of the HBI, supported by this legacy gift, will be to create the new leaders of the future, to take trainees and to provide them the tools, the support to be leaders and to discover new amazing things about the brain that will eventually help significantly improve our brain health. What we want to do at the HBI is to create a culture by which great ideas have a pathway forward where they can actually affect people and how people live in their daily lives.
Thanks to this generous legacy gift from Mr. Pickens, UCalgary is in the best possible position to make an even greater global impact. HBI researchers have already revolutionized the way the world treats stroke by discovering several new treatments that dissolve or pull clots from the brain. This work has reduced global mortality from the most severe ischemic strokes by half. Our researchers are leading in spinal cord injury research, piloting new technologies to control blood pressure, and helping people with neurological disorders to learn or relearn to walk. And HBI researchers have designed a bold strategy to tackle the heartbreaking addiction crisis. They've discovered a drug that could help people recover from opioid addiction. They're also launching new on-the-ground research with care providers and people with lived experience. These are just a few of HBI's many innovations, fueled by philanthropy, which are bringing hope to patients and families around the world. This will only be strengthened by Mr. Pickens' philanthropic leadership. The University of Calgary is tremendously grateful to him.
The T. Boone Pickens Cancer Hospital in Dallas, my dad was undergoing some cancer treatment there. Dad would go down quite regularly for his treatment, and in the meantime, he would go down to Boone's ranch with him and spend the weekends. I think for Boone, his gift to that hospital was just a recognition of that friendship.
Boone has associated himself with some of the finest medical institutions in the world. That was clearly his core area of giving, health and medical research. Again, because he believed it could have generational impact. MD Anderson, UT Southwestern, Baylor Scott & White, the Boone Pickens Hospice Center here in Dallas, and today the Hotchkiss Brain Institute. I will also tell you what Boone would hope is that others will step forward and give to take it all to new levels. He would say, "Job well done, but the job is not done."
I can just see Boone and my dad somewhere lifting a glass of scotch and toasting their friendship and toasting the HBI and all of its successes.